Hello everyone, welcome to this presentation on basics of modern rocketry by Udaan Club, the official robotics and aeromodeling club of NID Rourkela. Before moving on to the presentation, let's give a quick thought on what is exactly a rocket. Well, Google defines it as a cylindrical projectile that can be propelled to a great height or distance by the combustion of its contents. According to Wikipedia, a missile, spacecraft, aircraft, or other vehicle that obtains thrust from a rocket engine is defined as a rocket. But we at Udaan define it as a body with sufficient energy stored that can push itself up in the atmosphere and beyond. Well, there's no exact definition of a rocket. It's how we perceive it, what we want it to achieve, and how it can achieve that thing. We want it to propel itself up in the atmosphere. How it will do so? By using the energy stored inside it, inside the motor. So, now, then what exactly is a model rocket? Well, model rocketry is a sport that involves designing, constructing, and launching self-made rockets. This sport became popular in the 1950s in the United States. After the United States started building rockets, building satellites, and started the space missions. Well, not exactly it is a sport for us engineering students. It is a platform for us to try out and test our fundas, try out the concepts that we learn in the classrooms, the concepts of mechanics, of electronics, of propulsion, and so on, and test out this on field. And yeah, it's a sport too. Moving on, let's have a look at all the parts of a model rocket. First of all, the nose cone. The nose cone is the topmost part of a rocket, which causes the air to flow smoothly around the rocket. Well, it's designed aerodynamically in such a way that it faces a minimum amount of air resistance while the rocket is propelling itself up in the air. Nose cones are usually 3D printed or made out of plastic or PVC. Well, you can also use balsa wood, but generally the material for selection of nose cone is plastic or PVC so that it can be reused for every different launches. Nose cones come in a variety of shapes, from conical, ogive, parabolic, and ellipsoid. These different shapes give a variety of different aerodynamical resistance. We want you to explore these shapes, go search on the web and see how these different shapes give different properties to our rocket. The next matter, the next component, the body tube. Well, it's the casing that houses inside itself all the stuff, all the electronics, all the materials and everything of our rocket. It's generally made up of cardboard or PVC pipe to make the rocket light and maintain structural integrity. Well, structural integrity is an important property of the rocket. Your rocket, or to be specific, your model rocket should be structurally strong so that it won't disintegrate during its launch. Hence, cardboard or PVC pipe are there light as well as structurally strong. As said already, this is the place for the components. The next part, one of the most important component of a model rocket, the fins. Well, before explaining fins, I want you to go to the web and search why fins are not necessary in the actual rockets but are necessary in the model rockets. Go and see the model of Falcon Heavy or the Falcon 9. They don't have fins like while launching. They have the grid fins while coming down, but they don't have fins while they go up. Why? But we need these fins in the model rockets. Okay, so coming on. Fins provide the aerodynamic stability in a flight. Well, these structures, they help the rocket to align itself in an upright manner when the rocket is propelling up in the atmosphere. How did they do so? Well, we leave it for you to explore. Of course, we will be making further videos on how fins exactly provide aerodynamic stability. These are made from balsa wood. Balsa wood is a very lightweight material and it is easy to work with. You can cut various different shapes using balsa wood and give them a proper aerodynamic shape by using sandpaper. But one of the important thing while making fins is that the granular structure of the balsa wood. These grains should be aligned in such a way that when the air resistance force is acting upon these fins, they should not break. Like the fins shouldn't be aligned in the direction of motion of the rocket. These fins are also they come in various different shapes, from rectangular, trapezoidal and elliptical. The various different shapes offer a variety of different stability as well as different resistance values, air resistance values. In further videos, we will explore the various different shapes these fins come in and how their shape affect the stability of the rocket. The launch lock. The launch lock is basically a cylindrical component that holds the rocket on the launch pad while the rocket is building up speed. When you are launching on the rocket, you might have seen when the actual rockets launch, they are held by cables by a steel structure on the launch pad. Well, for us, the launch lock does the same work. It's generally cylindrical in shape and made up of plastic, and it is attached to the body tube nearer to the CG point. Okay. We will discuss further in the video what's a CG point and what's a CP point. Well, this provides the stability to the rocket just after the ignition. When the rocket is just ignited, there's a huge amount of force that affects the rocket. When the rocket is building up the speed, it needs to be stabilized so that it doesn't deviate from its path or it moves in a straight vertical upward path. The next component of importance, the parachute and shock. Obviously, we want our model rocket to return so that we can test various models. For that, we need the parachute and the shocker. The parachute slows the rocket descent and return them safely to the ground. Well, imagine, say our rocket has reached in a height of 500 meters, or for the fact, even 200 meters. In using your 12th class basic physics, you can see that the velocity at which it is approaching the ground. Imagine with such high velocity, what will be the momentum of even a 100 grams rocket? Hence, we need to slow down the speed of this rocket so that it can descend and land safely to the ground. The parachutes are generally made up of polythene and cellophane. You can use any other light material, but it should have certain strength so that it can withstand the air resistance force. The parachute is attached to the body of the rocket with the help of shock cords. These shock cords hold the parts of the rocket together after they separate at ejection. When the rocket reaches the apogee of the flight, the apogee is the highest point in the path of the rocket. When it reaches that point, it needs to descend. So while descending, the nose cone separates from the body tube and the parachute comes out. Both these parts are together held with the help of a shock cord and they are attached to the parachute. The shock cord is generally made up of elastic cord or braided in nylon. These nylon and elastic cord have a very high tensile strength and they do not break under a small amount of force. The next, the heart of the rocket, as we can say, the motor. You can see in the video here a demonstration of motor when it is ignited. The video courtesy goes to warp perception. You you can have a look at their YouTube channel. When the rocket motor is ignited with the help of this electricity charge is sparkled at the motor, it ignites. The rocket motor ignites and it burns the fuel inside it and provides the required thrust. This is the device in the model that creates the thrust force that propels the rocket into the air. You can watch the full video in the Warp Perception channel on YouTube. The propellant is the metal that burns to produce the required thrust. This propellant is cased inside the PVC or metal tube. Well, PVC is for amateur rocketers, so that you don't hurt yourself while experimenting with the motor. The metal tube is for more advanced high powered rocket motors that you will be experimenting when you have certain experience with the help of model rockets. Do check out the different types of model rocket motors, what is the amount of power packed inside the motor that is referred to in technical terms. There are various types of model rocket motors ranging from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. They indicate the amount of power that is stored inside the motor. We highly recommend you to check out the different types of model rocket motors, the amount of thrust they pack, and what the symbol means. We will let you know in further videos. Next, the most important part while designing a model rocket, the stability criteria. Well, stability is defined or is determined with the help of two points on the model rocket, the CG and the CP. Let's move on to the what is CG, what is CP. Before that, why stability is important. For any component, any type of machine to work, it needs to be stable first. If the component or the machine is not stable, then how can we expect it to perform its required functions? Stability criterion is therefore very important factor when designing your model rocket. Proving that your rocket is stable involves determining two points, the CG and the CP. Let's see what is the CG and the CP in the next videos. The CG, or the center of gravity. You might have known this in your class 12 curriculum. Well, the CG is the point, it's the balancing point on the rocket. It's where the gravitational force, the bulk of the gravitational force, acts on the rocket. You determine the CG of a prepared rocket. You pack the rocket with all the required components from the nose cone, the body tube, the motor, the fins, everything. But do not make it do not plug in the material so that the motor will ignite. Except that you make it ready launch. What is a ready launch, or what does it mean? This means that your rocket is finished, it's painted, the recovery system is properly prepared, and an engine is loaded in the rocket. The engine or the motor is the same thing for a model rocket. Then how do you find out the point of CG in your model rocket? Try to balance the model rocket on a point. You can first try to balance it on a line so that it doesn't topple. After that, you find that particular point on the rocket. When you you can use your finger for it also. When you balance it at that point, you might have tried this in your school days, balancing a pen on your finger. Well, that point is the center of gravity. Same goes for a model rocket. Next, coming on to the center of pressure. The center of pressure is the point on the rocket where all the aerodynamic forces balance. There is various aerodynamic forces that act on your model rocket while it's in flight. The major two are the lift force and the drag force. We will make a separate video on the lift force and the drag force. in further lectures. So it's that point where all these aerodynamic forces will be acting. Then how do you define the center of pressure? First, you make a cardboard cutout, like a 2D model of your rocket. You place the rocket in a cardboard, on a cardboard. You trace out the boundary outlines and you make a cardboard cutout of the rocket. Then you find that point on the cardboard cutout where you can balance it. The point where the cardboard cutout balances is the center of pressure. Well, it's not exactly this calculating the center of pressure, it includes a load of mathematics which is beyond the scope of this video. Therefore, it's an experimental way to find the center of pressure. Coming on, the stability criterion. You have till now you know about what is the CG point and the CP point. For a rocket to be stable, the CP point or the center of pressure point must be behind the center of gravity point. If it's even intersecting, or if the CP point is ahead of the CG point, then it leads to an unstable criterion. Then if you have a rocket with the center of pressure ahead of the center of gravity point, then how do you make it stable? We ask you to leave your comments in the comment section. We will let you know in the further videos. This is a very famous test known as the swing test for stability. You can watch this video. The video courtesy goes to LabRat Scientific. I will explain you the video. As you can see, a cord is tied around the rocket. The loop is tied around the CG point of the rocket. You can see in the video that the rocket is moving face upwards, that the nose cone is in the direction of the flight path of the rocket. Okay, if your rocket is not stable, then it will try to topple, or the nose will try to go behind, or it will try to align vertically. But if it is stable, it will move exactly as shown in this video. The video courtesy goes to LabRat Scientific. Check out their channel for more such videos on model rocket and their stability. With this, we come to the end of this video. Comment your doubts. We will try to solve all the doubts. We will try to reach out to you. Thank you.